Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
I am Beryl Thane, married to Christopher Thane, and I haven't prepared anything because, as a carer, I spent this morning sorting him out, getting him out, he's quite ill at the minute, getting him out of bed, getting him down to a wonderful provision they have in Blackburn with Darwin, Derwent Hall. That's a lifeline for me, is Derwent Hall. Chris goes there one day a week. So I haven't prepared, because I didn't know I was definitely coming. But I'm just going to, I jotted a few things down as you were speaking. Mark, I don't see myself as a carer. I see myself as a wife, a mother, a grandmother, and a great-grandmother, and a retired teacher. I adore my husband, and I want to do it. And whether I'm paid or not paid, and I'm going to put the question forward, would paying make any difference? No, it wouldn't. It wouldn't. But I've been really trying to track you down, Sam knows this, because I see all this team of people working down here as carers, and I am just so, so grateful for what Blackburn with Darwen have on offer. So thank you to all of you. So what I did, I sent you an email. This has been bugging me for about 4 months. And I'd also sent an email to head of Blackburn with Darwen Leisure and Culture. So I better put you in the picture, everybody. My husband Chris was head of a big faculty of science teachers at Witten Farm. We worked together. When he retired, he became a local councillor, and then under a coalition organisation, became executive member for Children's Services. So, you know, I am very conscious of what people, what of things that are on offer. So I'd written to, an email to head of Leisure and Culture, and to say how pleased we were with the provision. I mean, we go in there, and there's the poolside attendants. Are you all right, Chris? You know, greeted in the gym. Whatever we do, it's been just amazing. So I sent the email, and the next morning, wherever I went, and I said, thanks, Beryl, that was really good, because everybody got it. When I went to send it to you, I got a reply, a nice reply from your assistant, saying, I'll make certain it goes to everybody. You know, thank you for that. And that came here. I said, did you get my email? No. And I was really stung by that, because it's just a little thing, isn't it? It's nothing really. But it makes a difference if somebody's giving you a pat on the back. It really does make a difference. I don't want any patting on my back. Okay, that lecture over. So, having introduced myself, Sam said, your role as a carer. Well, my role as a carer, Chris was diagnosed 2.5 years ago. And over that 2.5 years, I've seen this very active, you know, he's still running marathons, at man slowly disappear from me. You know, every day you could almost see a deterioration. So, yeah, every day I'm doing a little bit more. My day starts at 7 o'clock at night when we go to bed, and we get all the clothes out for tomorrow. Chris is not really, he struggles now making a choice. So I'm discovering now, I'm best saying, you're wearing that tomorrow. You know, and it's just little things like that. And then, you know, the morning routine, when Chris was first diagnosed, I was asked, do you have a lot to do in the morning, in the bathroom? No, 2.5 years ago. Now, this is the bathroom, Chris. This is your toothbrush. This is your razor, Chris. Are you in now? Get your pyjamas off now. Get in the shower now, Chris. Here's the towel. You know, that has progressed in 2.5 years. I love doing it, but it's hard work. And I'm not a young mum of 23 like I was with two babies. I'm an old lady of 83 looking after an old man of 87. So it is hard. I cry a lot, got tissue here. So I try really hard to have a really good programme of activities because I'm an ex-teacher and I believe in stimulation. And I think that the more things I can put on offer, don't put two on offer at once now, Beryl. Don't say, would you like to do a jigsaw or should we play a gin rummy? Say, we are doing that one activity because that's all he can cope with at the minute. Making choices is difficult for him. So yeah, that's what I try to do, and that's my role. So Sam also said, And I want to go on to how the provision has been amazing for me. Well, you didn't use that word, I'm saying. I don't know how the system works. I know that when you're diagnosed with Alzheimer's, it goes to Alzheimer's Society, and they then put you on their books and they contact you. So, for example, through them, we access Singing for the Brain, which is at Brown Hill Church every Friday afternoon. I don't know what happens with the borough. I don't know whether when you've got a diagnosis, your GP lets you know. I don't know what happens. How do you actually identify all these people out there who are caring, who don't know they're doing it and don't know what is available? But for me, my story was, out of the blue, after the diagnosis, I suddenly started getting emails, and phone calls from a lady called Sonia, who works here, just to see if I was all right. I didn't even know this place existed. So I kept saying, yeah, I'm all right, because I was all right. And then as time went on, I thought, I'm not all right. And I have a counselling qualification myself, so I was really pleased to hear that. If you need some help, there's somebody who can help you. It took me 2 weeks to find Kingsway, and I've lived in Blackburn all my life, of driving round the streets, and eventually I came here and I saw a lovely girl called Lauren, who is a counsellor, and she listens. She's a good counsellor, she doesn't make any judgments. She allows me and gives me the space to make decisions for myself, which is the art of good counselling. Because I come in and sign in with this lovely lady at the back, then I see we've got these things, you know, all about what's going on. So I then started accessing, you know, I've been on the trips. We come here every, whatever it is, first Monday, is it, of the month, to find out what's going on. And I've met wonderful people like Kulsa, like Isma, who I give earache to all the time. And all of you, you're just so helpful. You are a lifeline. Absolutely brilliant. So I'm saying thank you to you. So Mark, can you make certain next time I send you an email that every one of my friends in this room gets that email and says, you know, they get a pat on the back.
Test me out.
I will do. Thank you for listening, everybody. Thank you.